One of the questions we often get asked is, how do you become an EFI tuner? Considering there is no formal qualification path that you can go down to make you an officially recognised EFI tuner, it can be a little bit tricky. So we're here at Pikes Peak with David Rowe from Electronic Performance Systems, or EPS, all the way from the UK. And we're going to find out how exactly David got into tuning. So, David, you are originally from Australia, but you've moved to the UK. You've been tuning for years. Can we go back to the early days? How did you actually get involved in tuning in the first place?
The way I got involved was I actually got a great job at Motec. So, right from the start, I worked from the factory. So, then I got employed as like a workshop technician, and then we got involved in customer support, and then we also had like the engine dyno at the facility as well. And so we used to like put engines on dynos, and then we used to test software from the engineers and blah blah blah. And it just evolved really, because you don't class yourself as a tuner when you're sort of working there to start with, and then all of a sudden, you know, your knowledge increases, and I think that's the joy of this industry, is like every day's a school day, and you sort of, you know, learn as you go along really.
So I think it's probably fair to say you started with a completely unfair advantage, getting an inside line with a manufacturer such as Motec. The point you just touched on, I wanted to sort of expand on a little bit as well, is one of the reasons why I still enjoy my job and I really love EFI tuning. No matter how much you may know, there is always more to learn. You simply never stop learning, and particularly with new technologies coming out. Before you actually started with Motec, had you any experience with EFI tuning, or were you straight in the deep end at Motec?
No, pretty much straight in the deep end, really. So, you know, we sort of... you know, this was sort of back in like 95 when we sort of got involved with Motec. And I remember, you know, we sort of, when I applied for the job, you sort of, you know, stretch the truth a bit for the old resume, and, you know, yeah, we know about computers, etc. And of course, you sort of, it wasn't really a known thing back then. And of course, you know, you sort of naturally get involved with computers, and, you know, you naturally sort of have an enthusiasm for it, and that sort of, you know, leads you to sort of where I am now really. So
Most people watching probably aren't going to be in a position to jump into a job with a manufacturer. So for those out there who are interested, maybe they're enthusiasts, or maybe they're wanting to learn a little bit more, could you give us your sort of insight into what skill sets you feel are important for an EFI tuner?
I think, you know, you need to sort of just either try to hang out with your local dyno centre or your local tuner and sort of get a bit of a feel for whether you're up for it, you know, because I've done it before where I've like trained people to do tuning and bits and pieces, and everything's fine in a classroom, but you still got to be good with a laptop while you're in a moving car and stuff like that as well. So, you know, I think, you know, get some good advice from, you know, surround yourself with some people that have done it before, and, you know, try to study as much as you can. And even if it involves, like, you know, fitting an aftermarket ECU to your road car or something like that, because, hey, if you don't get to work, you don't get paid, do you? So you got to get good at it, you know, quite quick. So
yeah, absolutely. I think one of the common questions we also get asked is, do you need to be, for example, a mechanic in order to be a tuner? What are your thoughts on that?
No, I don't think so. I think, you know, sometimes it's good to, you know, like be, I think with tuning, you have to be very specialised in a discipline. And I think if you just want to specialise in tuning, you don't sometimes need to know how a headlight globe lights up, or, you know, etc. So, you know, I think if you want to go down the tuning route, you know, you could just specifically specialise in that, and, you know, not worry about, you know, some other aspects of the car. Sometimes it's handy, because nowadays with, you know, most of the management systems, they're a big part of the car now, aren't they? You're also perhaps controlling gearboxes, and you're controlling electronic throttles, etc. So it is good to get a bit of a balance of both, really. So, you know,
I think probably a lot of people who are looking at the EFI industry from the outside think that we sit on the dyno with a laptop keyboard and that's the entirety of the job. And I wish that was the case, but of course there is fault finding. And I don't believe that being a mechanic is an essential aspect, but certainly some understanding of the interaction of the parts does help diagnosis go a little bit smoother. Now, obviously, there are plenty of tuners all around the world, and one of the reasons we are in existence is because the industry is a little bit problematic. Sadly, there are probably more tuners out there doing horrible work than there are likes of yourselves doing work at the very high level. So what in your opinion is the difference? What's got you to that level? Why have you strived to achieve and produce at such a high level where others maybe don't quite get to that point?
I think you know, like, you're only as good as your last job, and of course, you know, you've got to just be, you know, truthful with what you do. You know, if you're not sure about something, put your hand up so you don't know about it. And then, you know, if you work with customers that way, then you could soon evolve problems and, you know, sort of get to the good result in the end, really. So, yeah, just don't take the piss. That's the thing.
So. Pretty solid advice. Mm. I just want to move back to something else you mentioned there about putting an ECU in your own car, and this is certainly something that I'm a huge fan of, and definitely it's one of the things I did in my early days as well to sort of build up my own knowledge. Mm. However, I just wanted to also expand on that a little bit further in that, obviously, before we go and start playing, it's also important to have some understanding of what the fuel does, what the ignition does, and what we're actually trying to achieve. Otherwise, clearly, the results might be pretty second hand. Yeah. Which brings me to the next part of the question is, a lot of people believe that tuners blow up a lot of engines, and we've all heard the sort of theory that it takes a lot of broken eggs to make an omelette. I don't really abide by that belief too much myself. So what do you think about that? Is it an essential element to become a tuner to damage a few engines along the way?
I totally disagree with that as well, because... You know, like, I mean, you know, like, yeah, I mean, stuff goes wrong when you're trying to push limits and stuff like that. But, I mean, the amount of, like, dyno sessions that I've, like, stopped or tuning sessions that I haven't even started purely because, you know, even though you're a tuner, you know, like, it's not about getting the most power and whatever. It's about optimizing what the particular customer's got.
Yeah, sure.
You know, so... What, you know, the perception is basically you're trying to screw everything to the maximum and, you know, like, sort of, you know, get miracles out of every project. But it's not the case, is it? You know, you kind of, you know, if you're honest with customers and you sort of work with them and you can kind of show them, you know, if you know your stuff well, you kind of show people, like, you know, this is the limits. We've gone a little bit further. It's done this. And that's pretty much what you've got. And then... If you've got, you know, when you eventually get experience, et cetera, you could then sort of guide people and say, look, you know, maybe you should, like, do this, do that, you know, and then you could, like, evolve your projects and stuff like that. So,
yeah, I think probably my opinion is that if we're tuning a moderately powered street engine, something that's just mildly modified, unless there's already a mechanical problem with it, there really should be no reason for the engine to be damaged. So I think a lot of it is urban myth or urban legend. But on the flip side of that, if we are talking about some very high-powered engines that are seriously modified and we are pushing the limits, as you mentioned, then sometimes at that level, things can go wrong, and that's not necessarily the tuner's fault either. Okay, so moving on here, if someone's then trying to get work in the field, obviously a situation where they've already built up some experience of their own, what would your suggestion be on how they can approach getting into a position as a professional EFI tuner?
I think you just need to, you know, I mean, being in the right place at the right time is a good thing, and I think, you know, word will soon get around if you're sort of doing a good job on tuning and stuff like that. Because it is quite sought after, and you know people see your car running right, and then, you know, you get to start to tune your mate's cars, and then your mates talk to your mates, etc. That's the best way to sort of enter the industry, really, word of mouth, you know, because it's all good putting glossy magazines saying you could tune and whatever, but until you start, like, going face to face with some of these people, you know, you soon. You know, it's a good sort of bullshit factor is motorsport or, you know, tuning. So, you know, you'll soon sort people out that aren't really cracked up for the industry, really. So,
I think that probably pretty much echoes exactly my start in the industry, and I think it's something that is overlooked. Probably jumping in, trying to get jobs in the tuning industry with no experience on the board is probably pretty futile, and it's a really good idea to start building up your own personal brand and showing others that you actually know what you're doing, and if you're helping your mates out, then that's a good way of doing that. All right, look, thanks for the chat there, David. Great to get some insight there, and I appreciate the time.
Cheers, Andre. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Have
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.